Hello and welcome to WeLearn, Virtual Learning Network. This is session number 4th of the subject, The Study of Society, and the chapter is Complex Societies. Let's see the topics to be covered. Defining a complex society, modern society, post-industrial society. Defining a complex society. Now, what's a complex society? Technological advances from the stage of hunting and gathering to landing on the moon have given birth to a technologically advanced complex society in modern times. It means the modern times, the society is complex. The society is complicated with technological advances and with other options and facilities growing these days. Modern industrial nation-states are contrasted with the simple societies in various important ways. Larger territory and population membership, greater occupational differentiation and specialization of work and social groups. So, in nation-states, in modern nation-states, there is a larger territory and dense population. And the occupation, the work which they do have also differed. The work is more of now the sector which is industrial, the sector which is developmental, and there is specialization of work. The one which is expert in a particular work, that work is given to the person. Greater coordination in the management of the complex society. So, the way the affairs are managed in the complex society, there is greater coordination and there is greater cooperation between the people concerned. Quick rate of change in terms of consumer goods, forms of education. So, there is change in terms of consumer goods and services. The way consumer goods and services are produced, that is also changed, and the forms of education, the way education is delivered, the way it is taken, that is also changed with the coming of technology entering in the classrooms as well. Rural-urban dichotomy. Sociologists had earlier thought that there is a clear difference between the urban and the rural community. Some sociologists found that there was as much individualism, lack of understanding, fear and suspicion of strangers even among the villagers as it existed in the urban life. So as the fear and suspicion of strangers in the urban life is there, in the same way the fear and suspicion of the strangers is also there in the rural life. But both the kinds of communities and both the kinds of life differ greatly. Where the urban, the main way of producing livelihood is farming, is agriculture. In urban, the means of livelihood are the employment in various fields, and various options have taken up. So, the main source of earning in rural community is farming. Aspects of community life. Stages in family cycle determines choice of area within a social class. So stages in family cycle. So whatever the stages are there in family cycle, that determines the choice of area, that determines the choice where one lives, and also the class to which one belongs to. Young parents in a social class do not have as much to invest as those who are older. So young parents who are working, who have just started their future, they don't have as much to invest, they don't have as much money as those parents who are older. There are several constraints on where a person can live. There are also several limitations that where a person can live, in which area or in which place the person can live. The housing market makes a cluster of similar social class and stage in family cycle. So the housing market, the ones where a lot of people live together, form a cluster of similar social class of the same class and the same stage in a particular family cycle. So people belonging to the same social class and strata live in a housing market where a cluster of families stay. Some sociologists point out that it's the group that is influenced, not the community as such. They argue in favor of studying local social systems. So sociologists argue to study the local taste, the local systems, and the local way of behaving of the people to see and to actually study the community as such. They feel these should be studied with reference to maintenance and establishment, modifying circumstances, and interrelationships with national systems. So sociologists feel that these things should be studied to maintain and establish the community life, to modify or change the circumstances and situations, and to there should be the interrelationship or interdependence between the various national systems. Types of urbanization. There are three types of urbanization: over-urbanization, under-urbanization, and de-urbanization. The developing world is experiencing over-urbanization. So the countries which are developing, they are experiencing over-urbanization, where a lot of factories, a lot of industries, a lot of urban things are being facilitated there. Cities are enclaves which are surrounded by villages. So they are surrounded by villages and they are experiencing over-urbanization, where a lot of houses, markets and other things and industries and factories are situated and established. Modern society. Modern society has several features. These include profit motive production by big capitalists, technological advances. Profit motive production by big capitalists means that the big tycoons or the big industrial tycoons, they have the profit motive behind producing any product or service. Technological advances, that there are advances in technology, high rate of urban population, bureaucratic organization, and spread of education as well. There's greater spread of education and education facilities in the way the modern society is there, and the way the classroom education is delivered, and there is greater awareness about education as well. So here we studied about over-urbanization, under-urbanization, and de-urbanization. So under-urbanization is where urbanization, proper urbanization, has not taken place, where there is still scope of setting up factories or industries or big houses. So that is the meaning of under-urbanization. De-urbanization means that there has been already urbanization, factories and industries have been set up, but to curtail the ill effects of urbanization, it has been curbed, and various factories or various entities have been removed so that there can be de-urbanization and everything can be rechanged. Modern society. In contrast to over-urbanization in the developing world, there is under-urbanization in the Eastern Europe. There is a sense the opposite case relative to over-urbanization. So there is under-urbanization in the Eastern Europe. While the former is produced by industrialization and low rural employment opportunities, under-urbanization is a result of extra or over-industrialization accompanied by a lack of support systems like housing. So there is no support system like housing facilities in over-urbanization or over-industrialization. Community remains an important factor. It helps to study change. Even today, the idea of a good community is very strongly present. So community, the way community is there and the way people live together, that remains an important factor, and it helps to study the change which is occurring in the society. However, the connection between community and wider society must be kept in mind always. In modern society also, there are many varieties of subcultures and countercultures which represent a section of people. So in modern society also, there are many varieties of subcultures, countercultures, and other cultures which represent a section of people or a mass of people who live in that particular culture. Work in complex societies. Work in complex organizations means work that is paid. work you are doing and you are getting paid for that. However, work may not earn monetary wage. It may be time consuming and call for skill without being wage productive. For example, house repairs. Repairing the house, it can be time consuming and they can also call for skill and it is without being wage productive. In simple societies, the tendency is often to be partial towards leisure. So, there is more focus and emphasis on leisure. Work is thus mental or physical action that has some end result. So, work is considered either mental or a physical action which is done, which carries some end result. Work structures. Breuer's law, Malinowski, indicates that in the Tiberian Islands, many day-to-day tasks were overseen by a magician. Complex societies have specific workers or employees. These people have a common workplace away from home. Their work uses power and machinery and is supervised. So, they have a common workplace, these complex societies, specific workers, they have a common workplace which is away from their home and they have to work with the help of power, machinery and their work is also supervised by the seniors. So fixed hours have to be worked without a let up in effort. So there has to be fixed hours wherein the person has to give the output without a failure in the effort. The main attraction for the employees in a complex society is the wages they are paid. Is the money which they are paid the main attraction for the employees is that. They have to submit themselves to higher authorities, manager, supervisor, etc. while at work. So they have to obey the higher authorities, they have to respect the higher authorities in the organization. In complex societies, commercial office stress, timekeeping and ceaseless labor. So, in complex societies where commercial office stress is also there, timekeeping and managing the time and also managing the labor, that is also a key factor. Timekeeping is part and parcel of capitalist and modern work societies. Timekeeping, to keep the time and to also manage the time in a proper way, that is also the part and parcel of capitalist modern work modes. Alienation is a modern day fact in social life of the complex societies. So alienation is a modern day fact in the social life of the complex societies. Loneliness or people feeling aloof, that is a modern day fact. This is quite opposite of the tribal situation, for example, Kalahari Bushmen. Some sociologists have pointed out that simple societies have had a better life. It is not so mechanical and relentlessly time-oriented. So the earlier societies or the simple societies, they were not so mechanical, they were not so dependent towards the technology and relentlessly time was better managed. There is time enough for leisure also. However, in complex societies, the concept of leisure time has taken another meaning. So another meaning has attached to the time of leisure. Work has become the most vital aspect of life in complex societies and wage labor is an important factor in the area of work. So this defines the work structure of the complex society where it has become the most important aspect. To get the work done is also considered a kind of work. Some sociologists think that when work as an employment earning wages, a social status and standard of living pervades all areas of life as it does in a complex society, people's attitudes become exceedingly commercialized. So their attitudes have become exceedingly commercialized where an employment earning wages, where a person is working and earning wages, a social status pervades. And a standard of living also pervades in his or her areas of life as it is the same in the complex society and the attitudes of the people have become commercialized as well. Conflict in industry. In industry, the employer has control over the employee's labor over a particular time. The employer would like to use his employee in different capacities. So in different capacities, in different work, in different modes of work, the employer would like to use or extract the work of the employees. Therefore, he leaves the contract sufficiently vague. Nevertheless, work conditions and effort, technical qualifications, responsibility are areas of management, worker discussions and often disputes. So that is why the contract is left Wage and work conditions, technical qualifications, responsibilities, these are all areas of disputes sometimes and work discussions. The level of responsibility varies with the level in an organization. Higher positions carry higher responsibility and higher pay as well. Further conflict areas exist when attempts are made to put machines to work and remove workers. This is also called retrenchment of labor. When the machines are put to work and the workers or the human beings are removed from there, this is known as retrenchment of labor. It also exists when attempts are made to control them very closely. So that exists, that concept exists even there. Other methods require cooperation among workers to go slow, absenteeism and sabotage. People who take a long break from the work, that is known as sabotage, and absenteeism, where people take leaves, or there are also methods where people go slow. These methods may not show much on surface but cause great damage to management. Industrial conflict has most meaning when it is recognized by management as a just step. So industrial conflict has the most meaning when it is recognized as a just step by the management. Employment and women. In complex societies, appreciable headway has been made on employment of women. Women, however, remain separated from men in the work spheres as well. There is horizontal segregation in that women are mostly in clerical jobs, catering, receptionists, nursing, school teaching and so on. So these are some of the careers that are fixed for the women: clerical jobs, school teaching, catering or receptionists. The concept of two incomes has gained popularity since it raises the standard of living. Two incomes means the husband working as well as the wife working. It has gained popularity and it raises the standard of living. In most nuclear families in urban areas, men do contribute to the domestic work in one way or the other, out of choice or out of compulsion. So either out of choice or out of necessity, men do work, men do take care of the housework as well. As such, maternity leave is provided for in most jobs. Women also often spend time with their young. Women also spend time with their children as well. Even there is a provision for paternity leave which can be availed by the would-be father. So the father who is working can also get a paternity leave these days. Post-industrial society, that is a combination of various dimensions or features: service economy, professional and technicians, theoretical knowledge. Service economy, in which service is required, professional and technicians, where a particular work is required done by the technicians, and theoretical knowledge, that is only in the books. Further features, post-industrial societies manifest two more features. Technology planning. In modern society, some of technologies have proved to be harmful. Post-industrial societies have technology assessment to prevent any harmful effects of the technology. The government and people are much more aware of the possibility that the advance of technology can often lead to harmful side consequences. That even advance or even over-dependence on technology can lead to harmful consequences or side effects. Post-industrial societies manifest two more features. Intellectual technology. A new intellectual technology will be crucial to post-industrial society. It is not the machine technology of the modern age. Intellectual technology comprises management and other techniques needed to organize. So intellectual technology, that is required on the part of the management to organize things and to keep things in order. Vast use of computers and supercomputers and new mathematics is crucial. So technology, the use of technology computers is also crucial. Some trends. Post-industrial society depends for its emergence on the persistence of the present trends, state tasks, cultural change and ideologies. The task or the work which is stated, the cultural change and the ideologies, the way, the methodologies, everything that is there in the post-industrial society. So that was all about industry conflicts, management, higher pay, responsibilities and how to manage in a complex society. So these are some of the questions. You have to do it yourself. Question number one, what is a complex society? Question number two, write a brief note on conflict in industry in modern societies. Thank you. Happy learning. V-learning.